You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Thursday, September 9th, 2021. Now, this week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are talking about why we need to understand what we believe. So we talked about the fact that we were created to seek God. Our minds were created to question and seek truth. Talked about the fact that someday you will be an adult and you will need to make your own decision. I will follow the teachings of the Catholic faith or I will not. And then yesterday we talked about the reality that your faith will be under attack in one way or another, whether it's from well-meaning Protestant friends or it's from a society that claims that there is no truth, which we know is a terrible lie. Now, today we're on point number four, the fourth reason why you need to understand your faith. And this is because of a command that Christ left to his disciples and we have inherited. And that command is to go and convert the world. That's right. Even though it's scary, even though it's overwhelming to think about talking about our faith with people who aren't Catholic, who maybe have really strange ideas of the faith or even don't like us, we are called to convert the world. You are, I am. This is our job because we know, of course, that simply knowing Christ and knowing it is true is not enough. You can't just keep that truth to yourself. It's so good. It's changed your life, given you purpose and direction. You have the promise of eternal life waiting for you. You need to go and share that. Now, sometimes we don't like to think about hell. We don't really like to think about that. In fact, there are some even Protestant denominations that don't think anybody goes to hell. But we know that that is not true. In fact, just over 100 years ago, Mary appeared to three poor shepherd children in Fatima, Portugal. Children, remember? And during a series of apparitions, during one of them, she opened up the earth and she showed the children hell. She showed them what it looked like for souls that were sent to hell and were suffering there eternally. Now, again, this wasn't adults. This was children that she was showing. And the reason she was showing them this is to remind them, like, this is a reality. People do get sent here if they reject God. And that we need to be praying for people's conversion, even offering up our willing sacrifices for their conversion. And so when you know someone, especially someone that is close to you, that has rejected God, that is not living the teachings of the Catholic faith, that's not okay. It's not okay to just ignore it and say, okay, you do you. I'm going to be Catholic. You be whatever you want to be. That's a lie. That is a horrible lie. We are our brother's keepers. We're responsible for other people. And yes, we need to take care of their bodies, make sure they're healthy and safe. But our biggest obligation is to their souls, because this life is short. The eternity that is waiting for us after this life is much more important. So we really need to strive to bring as many souls to heaven with us as possible. It is not okay to simply understand your faith and then keep it to yourself. You have an obligation to understand your faith and then to prayerfully ask God to help you bring that to other people, to find the right way to speak to people, the right time, to be loving, to have a friendship with them. Of course, those things are all important. Christ didn't just get a loudspeaker and proclaim. He made relationships. And so that's, of course, how we convert the world. But we are unable to convert the world unless we understand God and we understand this great church that Christ himself founded when he was on earth. So, Sprouts, that's number four. We need to understand our faith so that we can do as Christ commanded us, convert the world. And so with this great mission and with this series coming up all year while we were talking about defenses of the faith, let us pray together our prayer. Oh God, I believe, increase my belief.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Well, friends, I hope you are as excited about this year's coming series as I am, where we walk through all of the defenses of the faith so that you can firmly and proudly declare, yes, I believe, I am Catholic, and I believe. We would love it if you shared our podcast with those that you might know, fellow teachers, homeschooling parents, or just Catholic parents with a drive to school in the morning like us. We just would love to bring the truth of the Catholic Church to as many homes, children, and adults as possible. It would mean just so much to us if you shared us on Facebook, sent a text message, or even just told someone in the carpool line. We depend on you to spread this podcast. Thank you so much for being here.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.